not gay at all because Snowbird's a chick. Sasquatch sex. Happy 4th of July, you guys. What's up? It's Sharmus Prime here doing another Marvel Select figure review on the Marvel Select Mark II War Machine from the Iron Man 3 movie. Gotta give a big thanks to MarvelousNews.com for setting me up with this figure. If you have not checked out MarvelousNews.com recently, you are missing out. They are the number one source for all Marvel-related news. And I have to say, this is a pretty decent figure. If you can't find it at your local comic book store, I recommend you go to Big Bad Toy Store.
Big, get your big badass toys at BigBadToyStore.com. Click the link in the description below.
The only Marvel Select War Machine figure that I have, so I'm stoked to have him. He's pretty badass. It's actually a pretty decent figure as far as the paint goes, or the paint choices go anyway. And he's a little bit cleaner compared to the Mark 42 Iron Man. Picture of the Mark 42 Iron Man, and you know, so you can see the gold paint applications missing right there. And he has fish lips right here, which I actually didn't notice, which I feel like a damn fool as a reviewer. Oh my god, it's so bad. But I don't know. I'll forgive myself, and I hope you do too. Sculpt isn't bad. Looks pretty cool. Looks pretty much, you know, like very much like the Iron Patriot and everything. If you look at the Hasbro Marvel Legend movie Iron Patriot, you know, you can see the lines are all in the right place and everything. It still has the FF 45 right there. Not as many decals as this Hasbro one. This part right here does look a little bare in comparison to this part. This looks like it has a little bit more going on, but we do have a little bit more articulation in the wrist section. Actually, I feel like there is a little bit more articulation in this figure overall. His gun turret right here is actually pretty damn cool, even though this kind of came off on me. Unfortunately, yeah, this just warped a little bit, sinking downwards a little, but other than that, it's okay. I do like the gunmetal paint throughout the figure. But to just go through the articulation of this guy, it actually moves side to side right here. You can move it up and down, and that just pops off easily. It rotates right here on this section, and it rotates on the back right here, even though it does pop off. So, you know, the pieces can be a little loose, but there's a lot more posability on this piece than compared to this one right here. I like that they've sculpted this ball joint right there inside his arm. And it seems like we have a lot of different colors of gray here. We have silver, we have this darker gray, this lighter gray, or I don't know, I call this gunmetal typically. And this is a nice shiny red paint going on right here in his unibeam. And same thing with the eyes. So I think that's pretty damn cool. And, you know, it's pretty consistent throughout. So even though it's, you know, mostly a gray figure, there is a lot of paint variation in there. One thing that kind of bums me out is I feel like the legs are painted a little differently. And I feel like one leg is a little lower than the other. I don't know, I just might be tripping. I feel like this one's just a little bit lower. And I do like that they've sculpted this part right here in his thigh. I wish, again, there's a little bit more of that going on in the front section. I wish we had these lines coming through in the front. I just hate seeing, like, this bare, clean part. But not too shabby. One thing that's a little bit of a bummer about this guy, he does not come with the interchangeable hands like the Mark 42 Iron Man did. Aside from the base, the only other accessory you get is the Don Cheadle head sculpt, which I think looks great. I think the paint came out great. The sculpt is awesome. I really think that looks like him. It has this weird thing where it's like you look dead on, it doesn't look like him as much as it does when you tilt to the side and everything. But that is just really, really nice. And as far as the size of the head goes compared to the clothes mask, yeah, this one looks like it, you know, the Don Cheadle one is a little bit bigger on him. But, you know, it looks great. And looking at it from far away with the Don Cheadle head, I think the proportions are actually pretty damn good. Actually, the articulation of the whole figure is very similar to the Mark 42. His head does move up a bit, and damn it, and for me right now it's not moving up, but you can pop the head off if you're looking under. Yeah! So this one's a little trickier to pop off right here, so you can pop it off, kind of half it on there and make him look up a little bit more. So yeah, there you go. That looks pretty cool. I think not too bad. His shoulder pads have some articulation right here, so that's pretty sweet. He has ball jointed shoulders, move forward, they move outward. Bicep swivel, single jointed elbow that moves right here. He has a forearm swivel right there, and you can see him getting a little bit of paint chipping on this figure. His wrists move down, they move up side to side. You can get him a pretty decent repulsor blast, so it's, you know, it's not really hindered, but unlike this guy right over here where you can't really get his wrist moving upward so much, that one, this one's a lot trickier. He has a very cool range of movement over here. I feel like this is maybe just a little bit too much space right here under the diaphragm section, but, you know, he can move very much side to side like so. He moves forward a decent amount, moves back pretty well. Pop this off, and yeah, and you could rotate it like this as well. His hips can move outward like so. The biggest bummer for me on this figure is that he can only move his legs forward that much. I mean, it doesn't really move forward much at all. That kind of sucks. That bums me out. It's really hindered by this piece right here at his waist, so that's a bummer. He has upper thigh swivel right here, double jointed knees. He has ankles that move downward a little bit. They move upward. You can rotate them side to side, and he has a gorgeous ankle pivot. I love that they're using that ankle pivot technology. Very nice. So there it is. Yeah, not too bad, huh? It's pretty much the same exact thing. Not pretty much. It is the same exact thing that we got from the Mark 42. I really like these things. I can't think of anything else that has been made for anything close to 6-inch scale figures for an Iron Man armory. And here we are with the two Marvel Selects that I came with. But if you want to put your 6-inch scale figures in there, I think that actually works out even better, man. Can you imagine a whole setup with these things? I think it would be so sick. So for any of you guys that already have these figures and you don't really care to have the base, you know, please go ahead, shoot it over to Shardimus Prime, P.O. Box 384, Pacifica, California, 94044. I think it would be really cool to have a huge setup full of them. It'd be so badass. At least 7 of them, or 8 of them anyway. So the base stands just right at about 8 inches, and the figure stands just over 7 inches tall, 7.5 inches tall. And here he is compared to the Mark 42 Iron Man, and he is just a little bit taller, which is, I don't know, kind of strange. And here he is compared to the Iron Man Legends Iron Patriot. And you know what? I have to say that overall, I think I really like this figure more. There will be a Disney Store exclusive version of this painted in the Iron Patriot colors, and we'll also get a Mark 42 and Battle Damage version, which will also be a Disney Store exclusive. So I'm looking forward to those two figures. Once that Iron Patriot comes out from this Marvel Select mold, I think that will definitely be better than this figure right here. And I actually really like this figure too. It's just that the posability is just actually, it's better. Even though he can kick all the way up, this one can't. His ankles can move all the way down. This one really can't, you know, just a little bit right there. So there's definitely, you know, some plus sides to each of them. If you pick this guy up, you're not going to be disappointed, and you can really appreciate the different variations of gray on the figure. So I dig it. I hope you have a happy 4th of July. This thing keeps coming off, and I will catch you guys later. Peace. Box 384 Pacifica, California 94044, and someone just got here. So, yeah.